The United Nations is ringing the alarm bells today. The UN Special Rapporteur for Human Rights in Myanmar says the junta's brutal crackdown on peaceful protesters are likely crimes against humanity. Now, you may remember this compelling emotional appeal from the country's own ambassador. He was speaking out against the violent military coup, asking the international community to use any means necessary to provide security for his people.
We need further strongest possible action from the international community to immediately end the military coup, to stop oppressing the innocent people, to return the state power to the people, and to restore the democracy.
At least 80 civilians have died since the junta overthrew the democratic government on February 1st. The United Nations Security Council has now just unanimously condemned the ongoing violence there, and it's calling for the release of the elected civilian leader, Aung San Suu Kyi. But there was no reference to the word coup in the statement, nor any call for specific further action. For its part, the junta says it respects the international community, but it is nonetheless forging ahead with its own plans. 11 people were killed in protests on Wednesday alone. In a moment, I'll talk with the British ambassador to the UN. But first, Kyaw Moe Tun, who issued that plea to the world that went viral last week, joins me from New York. Ambassador, welcome to the program. Can I just first ask you what gave you the courage to take on your own military regime and stand in front of the world and condemn them in public at the United Nations? What was going through your head at that time?
Thank you. Thank you so much for inviting me to this program. And it's of course, you know, it's the 1st of February is the day that many of us, including me, we feel like we lost our future. So then following days is make things getting worse. So we feel like where's our future? We don't want to go back to the system that we used to be in before. So that thing gave me a lot of courage to do that. To do the things that I on 26th of February, on the day that I deliver the statement.
Yeah, well, it was certainly courageous. So now, partly because of your courage, partly because of what's happening on the ground and civilians being killed, we've seen that the UN Security Council has had the meeting. It's made a statement. We've also seen the reaction from the junta in Myanmar saying, okay, you international community, thanks a lot, but we're just carrying on with what our plan is. They say their plan is to hold free and fair elections. What do you think is actually the plan? What will happen?
Thank you so much. First of all, I'd like to thank the members of the Security Council. You know, yesterday the presidential statement issued by the Security Council is by the consensus one, and so it's every member state had the veto. But that is why I'd like to thank. And the all member states, especially our pen holder, and the Ambassador Barbara of the United Kingdom, for her efforts to bring up the strongest possible messages from the Security Council. The thing that I like to say thanks is that we have the unifying voice from the Security Council, of course. That's not meet our expectation. I mean the expectation from the peoples of Myanmar. Because as you know, as you just mentioned, there is more than 80 people die, killed, murdered. So we all feel helpless. So we keep telling the international community that we need protection. So that because of that point, the statement issue, even though it's a thanking all the member state of the Security Council, we'd like to have stronger than what we have now. Mm-hmm. So with regard to the plan.
So
With regard to the plan, I don't think we need to have the re-election, because the election that we have on the 8th of November is very clear. It is a free and fair election, and the NLD have the landslide victory. So right after the election and right after the announcement of the result, many leaders of the world extended their congratulatory message to the Aung San Suu Kyi and the NLD. So to me, there's no need to have the re-election.
Right. So let me ask you this. You've just thanked the world community for standing with one voice and condemning the junta. They did not use the word coup in their statement. And also, we know that there was no specific plan or response outlined by the Security Council meeting overnight. And now Amnesty International is saying that the junta is using battlefield weapons on the streets in Myanmar against civilians, against peaceful protesters. What is it that you think the world can do to try to stop this, or is there nothing?
Thank you so much. So that is why I keep saying that, you know, we really need the protection. You know, this is now what we are facing is justice and injustice. And then a group of people with guns and ammunition, but the people, innocent people with no guns and no arms. So these kind of situation that we are facing. So I don't need to, you know, spell out, you know, how brutality that security forces are conducting in Myanmar. So a lot of people, you know, were killed. A lot of people were beaten. So it's sometimes when we see this kind of, you know, things on the social media and the, you know, the TV screens, we're speechless. We're very shocked. Mm-hmm. So we really need the help from the international community. You may recall that, you know, in my statement in the General Assembly on the 26th of February, I specifically appealed the international member state of the United Nations and the UN to condemn the military coup, to ask the military to release unconditionally and immediately our leaders, Aung San Suu Kyi, President Woo Win-min, and lawful detainees. And then we asked them, the international community, not to recognize the military regime and to restore the democracy and to return the state power to the people of Myanmar and to support the CRPH. That is specifically, I appeal the member state of the United Nations during my statement. But now things are moving. Mm-hmm. It's in the wrong direction. The situation is getting worse. So we all people, innocent people, innocent civilians, we feel really helpless. So that we really need the help. We really need the protection for the innocent civilian. So that is what we are looking forward to, have the help from the international community.